Back in ancient times, people liked to raise a various amount of different types of poultry, or birds, for their eggs, meat, and or beauty. They did it for self-sustainment and their families. Also, they did it as well for business, and they still do it today. As most of you know, most animals with feathers are birds. Do you know that they can control their body temperature, and most of the birds can control their own pupils? They come in a ginormous variety on the earth, and those that produce eggs, meat, or have features such as producing feathers that we use to decorate our clothing are called poultry. Some of those are chickens, ducks, turkeys, pheasants, and so forth. Another bird that's in the pheasant family is the peacock, also known as the peafowl. The females are actually called peahens, and the babies are called peachicks. The most commonly known peafowls are the ones from India. They are also in Pakistan and the island of Sri Lanka. Not only that, but they are also the national bird for India. The tail feathers of the peacock are up to 6 feet or 2 meters in length, and they are super beautiful, especially on the birds while seeing them in person. You might be wondering why they flash off their fancy tail feathers. The reason is so that they can attract a mate, then she'll lay eggs, incubate them, they hatch, and the cycle repeats itself all over again. Not only are the birds beautiful, but as many of us know is that we can use their feathers as home decor. Also for clothes, such as dresses. I think that took a lot of work. They are omnivorous, so they eat plants, flowers, insects, and small reptiles. They also have quite a few different morphs. Morphs are a change of color, pattern, or both. Before I get into the next topic on peacocks, there's one thing that I feel that I should share first. When we see one type of object, take a watermelon for example, or a few, we believe that those are the only ones that exist in the world, right? I'm guilty of that, but there are tons of different kinds of objects, watermelons, whatever it may be, that exist on this planet, and that's pretty much the same with everything, including peacocks. That at least is for here in North America. So we think there is just one thing of its kind, but actually not. There's tons of things. Just like, so the Indian peafowl is not the only peafowl in the world. There is another one in Asia called the green peafowl. They live in Southeast Asia in Myanmar, Burma. The bird is their national symbol, and they are also in Java. They are beautiful birds, and if we take the time to appreciate all that is around us, we will be given inspiration on what and how to do things we are struggling with in our lives. Another type of peafowl is the Congo peafowl. They live in Central Africa and are a lot different from the blue and green peafowl. I find them very pretty in a much more simplistic sort of way. Peafowls are in the same family as pheasants are. A certain type lives in the Philippines, and it's called the Palawan peacock pheasant, and they are very beautiful. Remember, no matter what, don't let the world limit you. Be that beautiful peacock inside of you, and let your colors shine. You become who you want to be, and what you want to be. If you can think it, you can be it. We just have to put all of our effort into what we desire, and He will do the rest. If we believe it, we can do it. I hope you have enjoyed my video. If so, please like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. You are amazing, and I hope to talk to you soon.